Before we offer the cantata, just want to say thank you to all these singers and musicians for all their hard work, and for Paul Reed doing our sound today, and for Kevin Fournier doing our projection show to give you the text so you can hear our music and also read the text in case that helps it go deeper. And Cheryl Brown, wave your hand. There she is. She made our PowerPoint. That's really our PowerPoint artist. And Nova Boudreaux is hiding back there, but she took the picture on your bulletin cover. That's a beautiful picture, and you'll see it on the screen too. So thanks to Nova for taking some new photos for us. If you have a cell phone, I hear they're quite common nowadays, make sure it's on silent. That'd be great. It probably already is, because worship started a while ago. And if you feel like applauding, you don't have to, because it's church, right? So we just offer the music, hoping you have a spiritual connection or an experience. But if you feel like applauding at any time, just save it for the end of the cantata. There's 10 pieces, and you could applaud at the end of that if you feel like it, okay? And thank you for coming. We're singing to you today Matthew's story of the birth of Jesus. This is mostly Matthew 1 and Matthew 2. And this, I say, is the darker of the Christmas stories. Luke's story is the one with the shepherds and the manger and the beautiful song of Mary and the throngs of angels singing in the sky. Matthew's story has a genocide in it of children under the age of 2. Matthew's story has a Mary who is given no voice at all. Matthew's story reaches out to a kind of a darkness, I think, that Luke does not, and for all kinds of reasons. But as you hear this story today, I just invite you to hear it for the first time. Wipe every Christmas card you've ever seen from your memory, right? Wipe all the carols. Pretend this is a new story for you. And hear and meet Joseph again for the first time. A man who in his vulnerable place of sleep is where God reaches him. Not in his wakedness. God reaches him in his sleep through dreams. What does that mean? Be curious about that. Think about, why would Matthew not give Mary anything to say? Imagine what that is about. Another vulnerable person given no voice. She has great power. She gives birth. The fetus of Christ is in her, and she gives birth to that unborn child. And then he's in the world. That's powerful faith. But she has nothing to say. There's huge diversity. Magi are of a different ethnic group. They're a different religious group. The wise men, they're called magi. Why would Matthew want diversity represented in this story? They come to worship a king of another faith. Interesting. Be curious about that. An evil King Herod. Big power. Big entitlement. Big insecurity. Imagine world leaders thinking of such things, behaving in such ways. And sometimes with Christmas stories or Bible stories, we do that thing of, oh, who am I in the story? I invite you to think about that. And we need to ask ourselves that with each person. How am I entitled? How am I oppressing people? How am I fearful? And ask ourselves the more joyful questions. How am I giving goodness to the world like Mary is, and such and such. Please hear this story for the first time.
Oh, Thank you. start new things. Please start new things. God, start new things. The light of the star led the wise men to him. The dreams of his father protected him. His mother made him new. When is my turn to reveal you? Get up, get up. There's a change in the plan. Don't go to Israel. For Herod's son has come to pass. Start new things. Start new things.
Oh, Actually, please remain standing as you're able. Wow, what joy. At this time, we come to the end of our service, and our commissioning is taken from Philippians, from Paul's letter to the Philippians. Paul writes, "Go into the world, showing a gentle attitude toward everyone. Be joyful. Fill your mind with those things that are good and deserve praise, things that are true, noble, right, pure, lovely, and honorable. Put into practice what you have heard here today, and may the God of joy be with you always. Amen." Our closing carol is Billions of Stars.
You'll know the tune.
Yeah.